So this sonata that I'm going to play is by Tim Berger, who was a composer in the court of Frederick the Great. As you probably know, or maybe you don't, Frederick the Great was a flute player, and he composed a lot of concertos. And he took flute lessons for years from Quantz. And so he surrounded himself with all these composers that, of course, composed for flute, because that's what he played. But this style of music is... it's really about contrast between soft and loud and sort of dramatic. It's not necessarily always meant to move us, but I feel like the sonata is really sort of a sonata, and it's pleasant, but then also there are these contrasts that you'll hear. So this style of music is very specific to that group of composers. So hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. are marked della Romanesca or sopra la basso de Romanesca. A Romanesca is a sequence of four chords with a simple repeating bass, which gives the groundwork for variations and improvisation. Our first piece by D'India has the text, "They weep with me, the beasts and stones. To my sighs they draw sighs too. The air moves as if in pity of my sorrow. It seems everyone says, moved by my grief, what are you doing here, poor wretch, sorrowful and alone?"
Thank you. straight ahead jazz. The composer Riccardo Lognini took a very popular madrigal, and many composers took this madrigal, and sort of set it to his own improvisation. The madrigal parts are all reduced either to a harpsichord, organ, or a lute, and you play the solo line, and I suppose you could do it with choir too, but I will do it with harpsichord.
Thank you.
as I mentioned, these next two pieces are also sopra la romanesca, but they could not be more different in character and temperament. The first piece is jolly and pastoral. I see the fields become green and fertile, and the flowered shores bloom, and lush with apples are the trees and branches. I hear the breezes breathe sweetly and playfully. The sun serenely spreads over the day and descends to take our fears away to merciful heaven. The second piece. Where I believe my hopes to be true, I find my faith bewildered. The heart sincere that loved with trust now sees itself hopelessly betrayed. Too late I notice that one cannot be faithful who has no faith.
Oh, Thank you.
start out with flute again. And we're going to play a suite for two flutes that are unaccompanied by Monteclair. And we don't really know much about Monteclair. In fact, there are no known portraits of him either. So we don't know what he looks like, but we know what he sounds like. So as with French music, this is a suite of dances. And so each one of these movements would have had a particular dance step to it. So I'll just leave it at that, and you'll definitely hear that these are melodically driven. In fact, you'll be leaving, and they'll be stuck in your head, and it won't be our fault. But they're good melodies, so it's okay.
Thank you.
peaceful calm. My soul rejoiced to put aside vanity for the peace that is prepared for me.
Thank you.
His father was also a gobbist who took lessons from both Forqueray and Marais. However, he didn't tell either of them that he was studying with the other one. Which is kind of an odd situation to be as a teacher. I know I find that odd if it happens as a teacher. But anyway, they were really mad when they found out. I guess they were bragging to each other about this talented student they had, and they said, "Well, let's get our students together and have them face off." And Hesse was the only one who showed up. So these are arrangements of Rameau opera settings and ballet settings for two gambas, and it seems like he was kind of interested in everybody having fun with it. So we threw in some other instruments. And the parts that the flutes and violins and harpsichords are playing are all from Rameau's hand. They're not just made up out of thin air.